Welcome. In this video, we'll see the arithmetic instructions of 8051. So we'll directly see the instructions and their demo in Keel Microgen 4 software. So here I will just first of all build it and we'll debug the program. So here first instruction is add a comma R7. So the meaning of this instruction is that the value present in R7 will be added with value present in accumulator and the result will be stored in accumulator. So here let us put some value in R7 register. So I will put 2 in R7 and I will again put 4 value in accumulator. So for simplicity purpose, I am taking small values so that the results can be verified. So the result of this instruction will be 4 plus 2 and result will be stored in accumulator. So the previous value which is present in accumulator, that will be now replaced by the result. So result here will be 4 plus 2 is 6. So accumulator will have value 6. So if I execute that instruction, so I got here 6. Also, this instruction is a register addressing mode instruction because both the operands are registers, and this is a 1-byte instruction because only one byte is required for storing the opcode of the instruction. Next instruction is add a comma 34 hex. Now here 34 hex is the memory location, that is RAM memory location. So the value present at this 34 hex address location will be added with the value present in accumulator. So let me put the value here at 34 hex location as say 1. So 1 will be added with the value present in accumulator, that is 6, and the result will be stored in accumulator. So if I execute this instruction, I get 6 plus 1, that is 7 in accumulator. So this instruction is again a direct addressing mode instruction because we have a direct address as one of the operand. And this instruction is of 2 bytes because 1 byte is required for the opcode and 1 byte is required for storing this direct address. Next instruction is move R0 comma hash 34 hex. Now this instruction is required whenever we want to use this R0 as a pointer for this instruction. So here we have just initialized the pointer to 34 hex. So this R0 pointer will point to 34 hex memory location in RAM. So with this instruction, 34 will be copied to R0. So we have got 34 in R0. Now with this instruction, the addition of the value present at the memory location pointed by R0 will be added with the value present in accumulator and the result will be stored in accumulator. So the value pointed by R0 pointer is at 34 hex location. So here we have 1 at 34 hex location. So that will be added with the value present in accumulator. So accumulator is having value 7. So when I execute this instruction, we get 8, that is 7 plus 1, 8 in accumulator. So this instruction is again a 1-byte instruction because only opcode is required for representing this instruction. Next instruction is add a comma hash 34 hex. So with this 34 hex is now the immediate data. In this instruction, 34 was the direct address, but here now it is preceding with a hash symbol. It means that this is the immediate data. So this 34 hex will be added with the value present in accumulator, that is 08, and the result will be stored in accumulator. So if I execute this instruction, the result in accumulator is 3C. So these are the simple addition instructions. The next version of these addition instructions are add C. And all the instructions are same, just a suffix is added, that is C in every instruction. So this C stands for carry. So this addition will take place like the value present in R7 will be added with value present in accumulator and the status of carry flag will be added. So if carry flag is 1, 1 will be added in the result. If carry flag is 0, nothing will be added in result. So it will be as it is. So that is the only difference between these instructions. Rest all the things are same. So I'll just show the output of the first instruction, that is add C A comma R7. So in R7 we are having value 2, and let me put some value in accumulator, like for example 6, And another thing, here we have PSW in which the carry flag is present. Right now it is 0. I will make it as 1 for understanding the result of this instruction. So if I execute that instruction, I should get the result of result as 2 plus 6 plus 1, that is 1 is the carry flag. So 6 plus 2, that is 7, 8, and plus 1, that is 9. So I should get 9 in the accumulator. So I've got here 9. So that is how these instructions will work. Only carry flag will be added in the result. So rest is same as the previous instructions. So I will directly go to the sub instructions now. Next is subtraction instructions. Now one thing to remember here is that there are no simple sub instructions. This instruction is sub B. So sub B stands for borrow. So we don't have simple sub instructions, but instead of that we are having sub B instruction. Here the subtraction will take place like A minus the value present in R7 minus the borrow flag. So that result will be stored in accumulator. So here now first R7 is having value 2. Let me put some value here as 8. And in case of subtraction, the carry flag which is present in PSW, that will act as the borrow flag. So here let me make it 1. So the result present in accumulator will be the subtraction of this value, that is 8 minus 2 minus 1. So it will be 5. So if I execute that, I will get 5 in accumulator. So that is how the instruction will work. So this is again a 1-byte instruction and it is having register addressing mode. Next instruction is again sub B A comma 34 hex. So here the value present in accumulator minus the value present at 34 hex minus the borrow flag if it is present. If it is having 0, then the subtraction will be like A minus value present at 34 hex address location. So let me check the output. So the value present at 34 is 1. The value present in accumulator was 5. So 5 minus 1 is 4. Then borrow flag was 0. So we have got the result as 4. Next, this instruction is again of direct addressing mode, because this is the direct RAM address and this is a 2-byte instruction. 1 byte is required for opcode and 1 byte is required for direct address. Next is indirect addressing mode instruction. Here again we have to initialize this pointer to some value. So we have already initialized that R0 to 34 hex which is having 1. So again the result will be value present in accumulator minus the value present at the memory location pointed by R0 minus the borrow flag. So here the borrow flag right now it is 0. So the result will be 4 minus 1, that will be 3. So we have got here 3. Now this instruction is used for subtracting 34 hex from the value present in accumulator. So this is the immediate addressing mode instruction, which is again a 2-byte instruction. 1 byte is required for opcode and 1 byte is required for the 8-bit immediate data. So the result will be again, here we have got CF. Now the result we have got CF is because the value present in accumulator was 2 and minus the value 34 hex. So that gives a negative result. So this negative result is indicated in 2's complement format. So see, that's why we have got here CF. So again, here you can see that the borrow flag is also 1 to indicate that the first number was smaller than the second number. Next, we have instructions for multiplication. So for that, let me put some value in B register. So we have got here 2 value in B register. And let me make the value present in accumulator as again 4. So this multiplication instruction is used to multiply the contents of accumulator and B register. So we are having here 2 and 4 in A and B. So these two will be multiplied and result will be stored in A and B. So again, the lower byte of the result will be stored in accumulator and higher byte will be stored in B register. So if I execute this, I have got 4 into 2 is 8. So 8 in the accumulator, that is the lower byte, and upper byte is 00. So this is multiplication instruction. So again, next is division instruction. So here again, we have put 2 in B register and accumulator is having say 8. So this division will be performed like a divided by b. So a is having 8, b is having 2. So if I execute this instruction, the result in a will be 4. So the quotient is stored in accumulator and the remainder is stored in b register. So this is multiplication, that is mul ab and div ab are again 1 byte instructions, and those are having register addressing mode. So this DAA instruction is used to convert the number present in accumulator into BCD. So let us see now how that instruction works. So for example, if we have 6E in accumulator, so this number will be converted into BCD number. Now for that, again, we have to check the auxiliary carry flag. So as we can see, that lower nibble of this number is E, which is not a BCD number. So 6 will be added in this number when we execute that instruction. So after executing that instruction, 6 will be added in that, and the carry generated will be again added in the higher nibble. So the BCD number equivalent to 6E was 74. So in this way, this instruction can be used to convert any number into a BCD number. So this instruction is again a 1 byte instruction because it just requires opcode for its representation, and it is having register addressing mode. So this is about the arithmetic instructions available in 8051. In the next lecture, we'll see the logical instructions present in 8051. Thank you.